using his latest masterpiece, The Irishman. We're about to explore every one of Martin Scorsese's trademarks. Here's our list. Long tracking shots are easily one of Scorsese's favorite camera movements. This is a great way to establish both the sense of location and the area of focus. While that might make the editor's job a tad easier, the extras are another story. This is due to Scorsese's tracking shots, usually being very complex, featuring heavily choreographed movements and often needing several takes to get them just right. Hey, when people refer to you as the king of the tracking shot, you've got a reputation to uphold. Marty's films almost never start from the beginning.
What the fuck does that mean?
That just means that Marty likes to tell his stories in a non-linear fashion, usually starting things off in the middle or the very end of a character's journey. And as you can see from the opening shot of The Irishman, we're probably going to be working our way back. And thanks to some remarkable special effects, we do just that. The post-production trifecta you almost always find in a Scorsese film are slow-mo shots, freeze frames, and rapid editing. Slow motion is often used when you really want to accentuate the gravity of a specific moment and the impact it has on a character's life. That in it almost always looks cool. Freeze frames, on the other hand, are a great way to capture the essence of a character in a single shot. Are they pensive? Are they having the time of their lives? Did they get killed in an unceremonious fashion? Freeze frames are a great way to encapsulate all of that. Then there's rapid editing, which can help create a sense of anxiety or convey repetition, like it does in The Irishman. Many of Scorsese's films involve a cerebral trip through the mind and the world of a complicated protagonist. Marty likes to convey this kind of journey with characters narrating throughout the film's entire life's journey. Sure, this tends to break the old rule of thumb of show, don't tell, but when done the right way, these narrations can provide a nuanced, introspective tone, as if a character is looking back on evil deeds with newfound hindsight.
And when they say they're more than a little concerned, they're desperate.
And while my opinion might be somewhat biased, I think having a voiceover is the perfect way to tell a story. Those trademarks are pretty well known, but let's move on to some that really cook. If there's one subject matter that Scorsese seems to enjoy portraying on film, it's the irredeemable world of thieves, extortionists, dealers, and in The Irishman's case, hitmen. Along with these kind souls, you can definitely expect Marty to include a good bit of violence and profanity. And just in case you thought Scorsese has calmed down in his later years...
Who's that, you motherfucker?
No! I'll fucking kill you!
Dumb motherfucker!
Fucking cocksucker Kennedy has got his nose up my ass!
Get in the fucking car.
What the fuck is candy?
Get in the fucking car.
Goddamn Kennedys. I'm looking at
Jimmy.
The goddamn Kennedy.
Jimmy, the kid's language.
Oh, what difference does it make?
Scorsese has always enjoyed making brief appearances in his own work. However, this cameo is one you're really going to have to listen for.
All rise. Court is in session.
Good to hear from you, Marty. He's always been known to cast the occasional comedian. In The Irishman, there's Ray Romano. But did you catch the quick scene featuring Jim Norton as Don Rickles?
You a Jewish fella? Would you like to be?
If you're familiar with his other films, you've probably noticed that Marty alludes to the Catholic Church quite a bit. Many times, he uses this imagery to explore themes of guilt, a need for redemption, and other feelings your average Scorsese character might experience.
But you don't feel anything at all?
Well, most of them anyway. With New York as his hometown and NYU as his alma mater, the city that never sleeps has been quite an influence on the work of Scorsese. With more than half his films taking place in NYC, two of them literally named after it, there's just something about this city that keeps Marty coming back.
What the fuck does that mean?
Yeah, I was just getting to that. Okay, so you might be typing in the comments right now that The Irishman, while it did feature New York a little, the story mostly takes place in Philadelphia. And you're absolutely right, it does. That being said, Scorsese still shot most of it in the city that raised him. Those things are all very Marty, but if you really want to experience some peak Scorsese, it all boils down to one thing. Joe Pesci is no stranger to Scorsese films, nor is Harvey Keitel. But the actor that Scorsese has collaborated with the most is easily Robert De Niro. Scorsese has said that when it comes to De Niro, no other actor can provide the same power and excitement he does. And that must be true, because their team-ups have resulted in some of Marty's most acclaimed films, as well as De Niro's most celebrated performances. That being said, The Irishman is actually something of a reunion for the two, as they haven't worked together since 1995's Casino. While Leo DiCaprio seems to be becoming another Scorsese favorite, it'll be hard to top the magic of Bob and Marty. And boom! That's every Scorsese trademark found in The Irishman. Did we miss something? What are your favorite trademarks? Let us know in the comments.
What the fuck does that mean?